In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which box plots may be used to visualize data, including the simple fact that, in many instances, they are a far more robust solution for comparing quantitative measures which are grouped categorically than a similarly configured bar chart. This is because the box plot visualization allows you to compare a variety of statistical measures for each category, and leverage post hoc statistical tests in the form of comparison circles in order to aid you in the process of drawing meaningful conclusions from your comparisons. Box plots are a visualization type which is useful for examining data distributions and making comparisons of those distributions using a set of symbols. Here, you can see the general description of box plot symbols, lifted from Wikipedia. On the bottom, a normally distributed continuous variable is shown in the form of a histogram, and above, the box plot symbols corresponding to that distribution. The median is represented as a line. The first and third quartile, or 25th and 75th percentiles, are shown as the edges of the box, and extensions representing the tails of the distribution terminate at the upper and lower adjacent value. Spotfire represents these symbols for each categorical grouping in a vertical orientation. Data which falls outside of the upper and lower adjacent values is shown as individual markers, known as outside values. Also, in addition to the median, first and third quartile, and upper and lower adjacent values, other symbols can be added to your box plot visualization, including the average and the 95% confidence interval. We will also see that in the process of comparing y-axis values grouped by the categorical x-axis variable, you have the option of including comparison circles. It is important to understand how to interact with these comparison circles in order to interpret the results of this statistical test. Let's take a look at an example where several box plot visualizations have been configured. Use Open File to locate the example with Interpreting Box Plots in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. The underlying data table supporting this analysis represents data from different countries collected as part of the World Bank Open Data Initiative. Take note that there are 163 countries which are organized into 6 different continents. The continuous measures included in this data table reflect the level of a given country's communications technology adoption. If we proceed to the Box Plot Basics page, the visualization on the left indicates the default symbols which are presented when one creates a new Spotfire box plot. As indicated previously, these reflect the median, 25th and 75th percentile, and upper and lower adjacent values. In this example, those statistics reflect the number of telephone lines per 100 people for countries assigned to each continent. You can see that several countries in Africa and Asia have values which are outside the limit defined by the upper adjacent value, and these are displayed as individual markers. Beneath each set of symbols is a statistics table, which shows, by default, the count of countries, the median value for the number of telephone lines per 100 people, and the number of outlying markers, or countries, in that continent's category. Note, though, that these are just the default symbols. In this box plot, the same continuous measure is applied to the y-axis, and the same categorical grouping is applied to the x-axis. However, this time, symbols representing the average, as a dotted black line, and the 95% confidence interval, represented by the range of the black bar, have been added. Additionally, the position of the 10th and 90th percentiles for each continent have been added as horizontal reference lines. You might also have noticed that the outside values, represented as markers, have been spread out rather than being aligned along the center of each symbol set, as is seen in the default box plot. This property is called jittering, and the resulting spread of markers makes it easier to interact with individual markers for things like drill down to display tooltip information. A lot can be learned by an examination of these symbols, much more than if we were to view a comparably configured bar chart, which we can imagine here, displaying the average value for each continent. For example, the number of telephone lines in South American countries represents a relatively normal or bell-shaped distribution, while the values for African countries are skewed toward the lower end. 4 out of 6 of the outlier countries in Africa are above the 90th percentile, and these outliers contribute to the separation observed between the average and median values for African countries, a much larger separation than is seen for the South American countries. Telephone line values for countries in Europe and North America reflect some interesting differences. Although the range of values is overlapping and somewhat comparable, the measures of central tendency are much lower in North America as compared to Europe. And while the average values and 95% confidence intervals for Asia and South America are comparable, Asia has two countries which are substantial outliers from that distribution. In fact, the statistics table in this box plot has been adjusted to relate other statistical measures instead of the default values. So you can make a comparison of the actual average values for Asia versus South America. And note that the standard deviation for South America is much smaller than the standard deviation for Asia, which would be expected based on what we learned in the examination of the box plot symbols. The bottom line is that the box plot provides much more information to aid us in making informed comparisons than is provided by a simple bar chart visualization. On the next page, you can see that in addition to the symbols provided by the box plots themselves, you might also add reference lines which perform calculations to display the position of overall statistical values. In this example, the overall average, displayed as a dotted line, and the overall median, displayed as a solid line, were configured using the lines and curves section of the visualization properties dialog. So now we can compare the average and median number of mobile cellular subscriptions represented by the country within each continent to the average and median values for all countries. There are a few additional box plot settings options of which you should be aware. First, on this page, the box plot on the left displays the actual scale showing the number of fixed broadband internet subscribers per 100 people. However, notice that many of the 40 African countries have such low values that the distribution of those values is hard to evaluate on this scale. The box plot on the right uses a relative scale, which sets the values to range between 0 and 100% based upon the minimum and maximum values within each continent. While this configuration may be fine for examining relative differences in data distribution within each category, exercise caution in making any direct comparisons of symbols, like median values, across this plot. Another example is related on the next page, where two different columns have been added to the y-axis of the box plots. Consequently, the column names variable was assigned to the x-axis in order to separate the values from each column. This plot represents the distribution of mobile cellular users versus internet users on an actual scale, and this plot represents those same values normalized to a relative scale. Another optional feature is shown on the third plot on this page, where a histogram relating the frequency of values for each measure is displayed superimposed upon the other box plot symbols. Note that while the mobile cellular values appear to be at least somewhat normally distributed, quite a few values for internet users are skewed toward the lower end of the range. On the final page of this analysis document, a box plot displaying comparison circles has been configured. Each x-axis value is accompanied by a circle. Mousing over a circle will highlight the corresponding set of box plot symbols in order to help you relate the corresponding circle to its x-axis category. Another helpful thing to notice is that the circles are positioned in the y-axis direction with the center of the circle at the mean or average value. The size of each circle reflects the degree of variability around that mean value. More variability or spread around the mean results in a larger circle. In truth, the size of the circle is also dependent upon the alpha level which has been chosen for this statistical test, which is displayed here, along with the root mean standard error and Q statistic values. Based upon the stringency indicated by the alpha value, the circles created by this Tukey-Cramer statistical method, which do not overlap at all, clearly indicate a significant difference in data distribution. Therefore, we can state with confidence that there is a statistically significant difference between the average number of mobile cellular subscriptions per 100 people in European countries versus African countries. What about the countries of Asia versus Oceania? Note that if we identify and click on the circle associated with Asia, two things happen. First, the Asia circle darkens and all other circles, except one, turn gray. The one which does not turn gray is the circle which represents Africa. Second, a set of brackets appears beneath the box plot symbols, connecting certain symbol sets to the marked symbol set. Both of these visual cues relate the same result. The mean value for countries in Asia is not statistically significantly different than any other continents except for Africa. The fact that the circle for Africa is not gray and the lack of a connecting bracket both indicate a statistically significant difference in mean values between Asia and Africa. Although we do see an even greater difference between the mean values for countries in Asia and Oceania, the broader variability for oceanic countries, as evidenced by the larger 95% confidence interval of the mean, is the reason that this comparison does not meet our strict threshold requirements for statistical significance. If we wanted to relax our threshold a bit, we could visit the properties dialog for this visualization, go to the appearance section, slide the dialog aside, resize, and change our alpha level from 0.01 to 0.05. If you watch the comparison circles as we make this change, you will see that their sizes become smaller. If we close the properties dialog, you will also notice that the circle corresponding to Oceania is now indicated to be statistically significantly different from Asia. It wasn't before. Evidence for this change is the fact that the circle is no longer gray and the bracket no longer connects to the Oceania symbol set. We could click on a different circle, like the circle corresponding to Oceania, just to examine another statistical comparison result. It appears that while values for mobile cellular subscriptions in African countries is not statistically significantly different than oceanic countries, all other continents have a significantly higher level of mobile cellular subscriptions per 100 people. That is as far as we will go with respect to the interpretation of comparison circles in this learning module. But please note that if you want to know more about the comparison circles algorithm, you could return to the properties dialog, to the appearance section, and click the help button. Scrolling down through the documented list of options available in this section of the properties dialog, you can click here to review what comparison circles are and how to interact with them, and then scroll down to click the link which allows you to view the comparison circles algorithm, as well as the exact methods which are used for interpreting the degree of overlap between circles which results in statistical significance. Oftentimes, understanding the general mechanics taking place behind the scenes will aid you in the interpretation of your results.